This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. All right, we're going to figure out how to find the trig functions of an angle of 45 degrees or any multiple of 45 degrees. So let's see, a 45 degree angle goes out straight up here. And if you take any point on here, you might notice it's the same value for the x as it is for the y. So you could pick any point on here, but this is like the line y equals x. So you could pick 1, 1, 1 and a half, 1 and a half, 2, 2, etc. I'm going to go ahead and choose this order pair 1, 1. That just seems like the simplest one. But you could do this problem and be more general, pick anything you want. You could pick 2, 2 or 3, 3. So the question is, how am I going to get the trig functions here? I need to know the radius. And we know how to get the radius. It's just the square root of 1 squared plus 1 squared in this case, which is the square root of 1 plus 1 means the square root of 2. So for this ordered pair here on that terminal sine for the 45 degree angle, I've got x is 1, y is 1, and r is square root of 2. Once you have that, pretty simple to go ahead and figure out the sine. So let's say the sine of 45 degrees. That will be y over r, so it's 1 over square root of 2. Or if you multiply the numerator and denominator by square root of 2, that's the same thing as square root of 2 over 2. I'm not going to show that step, but that's the same thing as square root of 2 over 2. Cosine of 45 degrees. You take the x over the r, well, you get the same thing. 1 over square root of 2, which is the same thing as square root of 2 over 2. And the tangent of 45 degrees would be y over x. So in this case, it'd be 1 over 1, which is 1. Now, once you have the sine, you could take the reciprocal to get the cosecant. So the cosecant of 45 degrees, take the original one here, it's easier. 1 over square root of 2, the reciprocal is just square root of 2 over 1, which is square root of 2. The secant of 45 degrees, same thing. It's the reciprocal of the cosine, so square root of 2 over 1 is just square root of 2. And the cotangent is the reciprocal of the tangent, so it's just going to be 1. So here we have the sine, cosine, tangent, cosecant, secant, and the cotangent of 45 degrees. Often when we look at 45 degrees, we think of that as the 45, 45, 90 degree triangle, and you'll see it written like this. One square root of 2, you know that's your 45 degree triangle. This 45 degrees right here, for instance. So if you were just looking at it as a triangle. But we will be doing some problems where we have it in a different quadrant. So we could do multiples of 45, so like 135 degrees, for instance, is 45 times 3. All right, so here's a problem. Find the exact value of cosine of 135 degrees and tangent of 135 degrees. So if we draw this picture, 135 degrees over here in second quadrant, and there we are with a 45 degree angle right here. You see it down here, this is 135 degrees, but this is like a 45 degree angle to get back to the 180, by the way. So knowing that that is a 45 degree angle, we should be able to figure out an ordered pair on here. We know that the x and y value are basically the same length, but the x is negative here, right? So how about choosing negative 1, positive 1, right? I always choose either 1, 1, or negative 1, 1, or negative 1 down here in quadrant 3, or 1, negative 1. I'm sorry. Yes, 1, negative 1 down in quadrant 4. And that way we've got the radius is always going to be square root of 2. Now, we can see then that x is negative 1, y is 1, and r is square root of 2. So now we're ready. Cosine of 135 degrees would be the x value over the r value, right? It's x over r, so it's negative 1 over square root of 2. And if you rationalize the denominator, that's the same as negative square root of 2 over 2. If you need help rationalizing the denominator, then look at my videos on radicals and rationalizing the denominator. All right, how about tangent of 135 degrees? The tangent is y over x. So that would be 1 over negative 1 or negative 1. So we found the cosine and the tangent. All right, I'm going to show you my unorthodox way of figuring this out and drawing my angle. So what I do is instead of writing this ordered pair, negative 1, 1, I'm going to do it in green. I usually just put the x value along the x side. Now, obviously, that's not negative 1 space, right? It just means that would be the x value, and this would be the y value, 1. And then I look for my cosine, I just look at my x value over my r, and I get negative 1 over square root of 2. And my y value, if I were going to do the sine, would be 1 over square root of 2. And my tangent would be my y over x, it'd be 1 over negative 1. So this is an unorthodox way of writing it as opposed to writing an ordered pair. It works for me. I look at this triangle basically, but I pay attention that it's really this x value is negative, right? It's going to the left, so I just write the minus sign in front of it. So let me show you what it might look the way I do it, a different problem. All right, so let's say we're doing this problem. Find the exact value of the cotangent of negative pi over 4 and the sine of negative pi over 4. So I'm going negative, and to be honest, I think of pi over 4 as 45 degrees. So I think if this is negative 45 degrees, I recognize that. So I know it's going here, and I know that's the 45 degree angle. So the way I label it is 1, and then this is negative 1, and that's the square root of 2. So I always personally think of it that way. But it just means when I write 1, negative 1, that if you wanted to write it as an ordered pair, that's what the ordered pair would look like. In any case, x is 1 and y is still negative 1 and r is still square root of 2. So the cotangent all right, so what's the cotangent? It's x over y, or you could think of it as the reciprocal of the tangent, but I'm just going to think of it as x over y, 1 over negative 1. But if I looked at the picture, I just think of it this way, x over y, 1 over negative 1. I usually don't write this out. And the sine of negative pi over 4, so I'm going to let you see it through my eyes. I look at the picture and I do the y over the hypotenuse here, which is the r value. So it's negative 1 over square root of 2, which is the same thing as negative square root of 2 over 2. Okay, so it's up to you how you kind of label it. You know, this is kind of unorthodox. People say, oh, you can't put a negative 1 there. Well, that's just my own little notation to help me out. It's up to you. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.